Blackstone Audio presents Lives of the Explorers, Discoveries, Disasters, and What the Neighbors Thought by Kathleen Krull. This book is read by Amanda Dolan. Welcome to Cassius and Julius, Current and Future Explorers, KK. To Steve and Young, Man Was Born with Legs, Not Roots, R. Buckminster Fuller, KH. Lives of the Explorers, Introduction. Exploring the unknown, it's what humans do. Since the beginning of time, we've wanted to know what else might be out there. Though many explorers are lost to history, we know some by name. Here, presented chronologically, are the biographies of 20 bright stars of geography. Other books trace the east, west, north, south details of their journeys to faraway countries, referred to here by their present-day names, though they might have been called something else in the past. This book is about the explorers as human beings, warts, egos, and all. Some were not well-liked by their neighbors or anyone else. Many were cruel. But all were bold and determined. These were men and women who took a deep breath, got up out of their chairs, and went adventuring by land, sea, or air. Their motives varied. Many were lured by glamour and the possibility of riches. Others were driven by a curiosity or a passion for expanding human knowledge about the world. Still, others wanted to escape the boredom of their settled lives. The journey of a heroic explorer, especially if he or she was a good writer, which many of these were, often inspired others to get moving. The stress of facing the unknown day after day is not for the faint of heart. Homesickness was the least of an explorer's problems. Who had to follow a path of bones, human and animal, across the sands of the Sea of Death? Polo. Whose cat screamed across the deck, warning of disaster? Hudson's. Which explorer had a young crew of more than 250, of whom only 18 made it home? Magellan. Who lost 11 of his crew to cannibals? Cook. Who was accidentally shot by one of his own men? Lewis. Who emerged from a swamp covered in black slime and leeches, weak from loss of blood? Kingsley. Which ones got totally lost? Columbus. And many others. Who survived kidnapping? Batuta and Boone. Who was taunted, spat at, stoned, and had people try to break down her door? Bird. And some explorers failed to survive at all. Their trips were life-or-death journeys with every possible danger, few conveniences, and no GPS. Many of the courageous people here were inspired by books about explorers that they'd read in childhood. May this book inspire you to also forge new paths, remaining brave and full of wonder even when everything ahead of you is unknown. Kathleen Krull. In Search of Trees, Leif Erikson, born in Iceland, 970, died in Greenland, 1020. Viking, famed as the first European to set foot in North America. Even baby Vikings knew their way around a boat. And Leif Erikson knew more than most. He grew up on a cliff overlooking the ocean, in a house made of mud and stone. His dad, Erik the Red, had come from Scandinavia and discovered Greenland, and the family settled in one of its nicer areas. But the winters seemed endless, and there were no trees. No green, ironically. No shade, no timber for building houses. Erikson grew up hearing magical tales of lands covered with forests. At about age 21, taking along some 30 others, he set out to find them. In sagas told around the fire for the next 10 centuries, Erikson was a large, strong man of very striking appearance and wise, as well as being a man of moderation in all things. Vikings in general were more famous for fierceness than moderation. They carried weapons at all times, axes, swords, arrows, spears, wore shirts made of bearskin, and howled like wolves to frighten their enemies. Aboard ship, Erikson's men ate fresh whale, seal, or caribou, At night, they passed the time with stories about Thor and other gods. They played a game similar to chess. They carved spoons or figurines of gods from wood or bone. They doubled up to sleep in the animal skin sacks that they used for holding tools. Erikson landed in North America very pleased indeed. Temperatures were above freezing. Huge salmon jumped out of the rivers. The green grass would feed the livestock, and the landscape was dense with trees. He spent the winter and then sailed home, his boat loaded with...
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.